it was just an absolute whirlwind. This is Behind the FX.
Here we go, ready and action.
It was really important to Jude and the whole team that we have a fun and sort of light atmosphere about the filmmaking itself, had a good energy and sort of celebrate Hawaii.
Boom, step, pop, boom, step, pop, step, boom, step, pop, boom, step, pop, step.
This was my first movie. I'm by no means like an experienced, seasoned actor, and even more so, I'm not an experienced visual effects or special effects, you know, ambassador.
What the?
Is the floor literally lava?
So at this point in the movie, we've pretty much gone through a bunch of hardships. There's no turning back, and we find a bridge. And we're finally like, okay, cool. Finally, like a nice little break. Great, awesome. Boom, everything explodes. Bridge collapses. There goes our out.
There's a real bridge, and there's a real rope component that breaks. We're always looking for opportunities where we can add a little something to sort of sell the drama or sell the danger or tell the story in a more impactful way. We added more of ledge, we added more lava, we added some smoke billowing up.
It definitely was not in working condition. It was a tattered old bridge. And they had actually set it with explosives so that the bridge could actually collapse in real time. And we filmed that sequence with the explosives first and then without the explosives multiple times.
As a visual effects artist, I think I've added dust and debris and breaking stuff to 5,000 shots over the course of my career. It's a staple of the visual effects artist toolbox to add breaking dust and little bits of debris.
You're feeling like, whoa, he just dodged a bullet or a piece of wood.
We did not throw pieces of wood at Alex.
Okay. Yeah, not a big deal.
What you think about it, it's really a piece of care.
Okay, no, I can't do this.
What?
No,
I guess you can, you just gotta keep...
Don't tell me what I can and can't do. I mean, you almost fell.
At this point, we're in a real cave in Thailand. And the ground, it was still pretty high. I mean, we're talking probably 15, 20 feet in the air. You know, in your mind, if I fall over this, I'm dead for sure.
But this cave did not have the ledge component and it didn't go down to lava. And so what we did was we used the best of what was available. We dressed the surrounding real environment and we draped fabric on the floor, green screen fabric.
What you think about it, it's really a piece of care.
That's a shot that I sold the director on. We wanted to tell the story of how far up the kids were, and we wanted to increase the sort of jeopardy. So one of the things you can always do is have the camera sort of go along for a ride and pull back to see how far the drop is. And then we added a couple of Easter eggs. If you're really careful, you can see there's a skeleton that's sort of punctured onto one of the rock outcroppings. We're always looking to get as much in camera as we can.
They had a big air cannon that shot out that helped create, I think, the effect of bats flying through. And they'd shoot it without telling us, so you actually do get scared. And so a lot of the times, those reactions were actually real reactions.
What? They're like a bioluminescent algae.
Hey, I don't want to be that guy, but does anybody see a way out? Because I don't.
Even early on, we were looking at footage of what bioluminescence looks like. And so what we did was we did it in parts. We had all this great lighting from the guys on set. All these pinpoint dots in the ceiling were created by LEDs.
My imagination, it helps the room breathe a little bit.
But when the kids move into the water, you'll see that the water also activates. We actually created doubles of the children. And then what we're doing is we're using our computer graphic lights to illuminate the kids, but sort of the computer equivalent, and then we combine it all in the composite to make it look like they're being lit by their underside by the algae.
On the count of three! One, two, three!
The banyan root jump scene is definitely the most intricate of the shots. We step out onto that ledge and we look over and we see this. There was maybe 2 feet underneath that ledge, there was a pad. We were in a studio. We had to look down and pretend we're up 150 feet. And they kind of put us in a tiny little speckle on the screen and make this whole universe that we had never seen. It was a drone shot. And that look kind of shows how big and how high up we actually are in the movie.
One of the great things about this movie was recreating this jungle waterfall ledge. We went to Tilo Su Falls, which is on the border of Thailand and Myanmar, and we shot for the first time ever, this fantastic waterfalls. We combined our work on stage with the drone shots on this waterfall, and we put our kids into that environment. In the context of the movie, Alex has to jump off of this ledge. It was probably like 40 or 50 feet high. So there's safety constraints.
Action!
They let me do the actual jump into the water with no harness and no wire. I'm jumping off this forklift. It was probably only like 20 or 30 feet. I'm gonna say it was like 60, 70 feet. And as every year that I get older, it's gonna get more. And by the end of it, by the time I die, it's 1,000-foot drop.
Hi.
From A to Z, there you go. That's the banyan scene.
That is not a cute wolf spider.
That is not a wolf spider.
Why does it have so many eyes?
Sadly for Alex, he didn't have a real spider to act against.
They would draw certain dots in areas, and they didn't make sense sometimes. Like sometimes I thought they were just throwing, like closing their eyes and like throwing dots in places. But every single one of those dots apparently held importance to creating those spiders.
He's acting with the dots on his hand. Then we have a paint artist back at Industrial Light and Magic that removes the little dots. And then we do what's called a match move of his hands. Our spider animation lives on top of a proxy hand. And then we replace that and we light it. And then we composite it into the shot.
I'm getting shivers up my spine talking about it. I give so much credit to ILM for creating incredible, like the spider on my hand. It made me think, wait a second, did we do a couple shots where they just dropped a little spider on my, like it's so real.
It's always wonderful when Alex or any of the other cast members can't remember what was fake, what was real. We're always endeavoring to make it look seamless, and it's a great compliment.
You can check out the whole film, Finding Ohana, now streaming on Netflix.